What's up, YouTube? This is Brian from Bull Strength coming at you with another video, and today we're going to talk about CBD. CBD oil. So what is it? What is CBD? CBD stands for cannabidiol. I know, it's a mouthful. Cannabidiol is a cannabinoid. Yeah, say that 10 times fast. So basically it's derived from the cannabis plant, and it is linked to all kinds of anti-inflammatory benefits, which we'll get into in a second. It's basically a completely natural, non-toxic miracle drug. And even though it is derived from the cannabis plant, it doesn't actually have any psychoactive properties. So it's not going to get you high. You're not going to be catatonic and, you know, eating Doritos on your couch after ingesting some of this. It's completely harmless. So according to the Journal for Experimental Medicine, it has been proven to reduce inflammation. It relieves pain. So it's a legitimate anti-inflammatory. And these anti-inflammatory effects carry over into brain health, cardiovascular health. Like the cardiovascular inflammation that you typically get from consuming high amounts of glucose, CBD has actually been found to counter those effects, which is really cool. Another thing is, you know, it's anti-inflammatory on your brain. So a lot of inflammation-induced disorders, like ones that cause seizures, social anxiety, just anxiety in general, it actually relieves a lot of these symptoms. So basically there was a study done by the National Institute of Health where they had a bunch of people take CBD and take a placebo in two different groups, and they had them basically do a stressful public speaking type event. And it found that the people who were on the CBD actually had reduced blood pressure and therefore reduced anxiety. So people on CBD oil were actually capable of public speaking. So yeah, if you're going into a social situation, you know, maybe a milligram or two of CBD might relieve some of the stress. It might take some of the edge off. So another study done by the National Institute of Health showed that CBD had actually caused cell death in certain cancer cells. So the ones that have been actually studied are lung cancer, colon cancer, and breast cancer. And CBD use had actually caused some of those tumors to lose some of their cancerous cells. So it's anti-cancer, it's anti-inflammatory. It also counters the effects of memory loss, specifically due to THC ingestion. So if you're a pothead, you like smoking weed or whatever, a little CBD will actually go a long way in preserving your short-term memory, because we all know short-term memory loss is a side effect of consuming too much cannabis. So yeah, I mean, it's a miracle. It's a miracle drug. It is fantastic. You know, I use it every night. It helps me fall asleep. One of the problems I have when I get into bed is I can't get my mind to stop. You know what I mean? Like, I'm always thinking of stuff. And the CBD really takes the edge off, and, you know, it helps me have a very restful sleep whenever I use it, which is pretty much every night. Yeah, so this is a super beneficial drug. Now, it's derived from the cannabis plant. So how does the federal government view CBD? Well, since according to the federal government, there are no medical benefits from ingesting cannabis, CBD is right up there. It is technically a Schedule I drug that's kind of flying under the radar right now, which is ridiculous. I mean, the fact that you're putting a harmless, non-toxic oil, you know, in the same category as methamphetamine and like heroin, that's crazy. It's absolutely insane. But, you know, the federal government, you know, they put out recently that they're sticking to their guns. And, you know, there could be a massive culling of all of these CBD distributors here, hopefully not, but possibly in the near future, we could end up seeing something like that. But yeah, the fact that the federal government refuses to see cannabis and CBD as being medically beneficial is just, it's so dishonest. And it's so obvious that, you know, Big Pharma definitely has their hands in this decision as well. So as of the last couple days, Texas is actually driving to put an all-out ban on CBD, okay? They're saying CBD is the same as cannabis, which is basically the same as methamphetamine. So they want to make it illegal. Meanwhile, Big Pharma is like literally selling amphetamines and causing a massive drug crisis in this country. But hey, you know, they're legitimate because you go to a pharmacist, right? Just because it's an addictive drug that really screws up your brain and can make you have suicidal thoughts and homicidal thoughts. Yeah, because it was prescribed by a doctor, that's legitimate, right? I mean, I don't even want to get into it. But all these shooters that have been happening, from Vegas to school shootings to all of them, they have one thing in common, okay? Besides the fact that they're using guns, they're all on psychotropic medication, okay? So let's call out the actual elephant in the room here, okay? CBD is not the bad guy. Cannabis is not the bad guy. There are obvious medical benefits to both of these things. You know, their CBD comes from cannabis, but I'm kind of putting them in two different categories here. But it's very obvious that these are medically beneficial drugs, and Big Pharma doesn't want competition, and they especially don't want competition that you can grow in your backyard, because that's going to take away from their business. Messed up, right? I can't stand this issue in general. It really bothers me. But anyway, on that note, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one. Please like and subscribe, and peace out.